In this session, we will go through how to generate a time and material invoice through the job contracts application. First thing we'd like to do is just review and make sure everything is set up and ready to go. In jobs, under job contracts, you want to make sure that the job that you have set up, the contract, is linked to the rate tables, and there is a job contract set up for it. So if I go into Intacct T&M, I'm going to go take a look at the lines on the T&M contract, and I'm going to click view or edit and make sure that I have all the fields set up that I need, including rate tables. And as you can see, we have the rate tables set up ready to go. I also want to make sure that inside my rate tables under jobs, setup, job contracts, rate tables, I have the correct rate table and the percentages set up inside the rate table as well. So again, if I click on the 10% rate table, click edit, and I can review my rate table setup from the prior enablement sessions. At that point, what you can do is you can go and review and see if there are some costs ready to be billed out in the system. There's a few reports you can run. One of them is in the Jobs Project module under All, and there is a report under Project Reports called Project Expense Summary. You can also use the Billable Cost by Project Report. If you click on the Project Expense Summary, what you can do is, depending on how you have your project type set up, in this sample, we set up a project type called T&M Projects, so I can filter just on all my time and material projects. And it will just show those projects, and I'll click view. And you'll notice I have one project ready that has billable expenses, $36,000, and it will also show you which portion of that has already been billed, and which portion, if any, is unbilled ready to go. So there's $35,000 of unbilled expenses. So now I'm ready to go in and generate an invoice. I can go into jobs, invoices, generate invoices. And this is also where you do your progress billing invoices as well. Once you're in the Generate Invoices under Invoice Options, change the invoice by to Job Contracts. And what you'll notice is you should have your template set up as to what type of project contract you want to bill out. And in this scenario, I have one set up here for Project T&M Invoice. And you can notice here the progress billing contract invoice is available here as well. So we're going to do T&M invoice. At this point, I could fill out my dates. What do I want my invoice date to be? We'll say December 30th. And what am I billing through? So we want to bill through costs through December 30th as well. At this point, I could generate and see all the projects at one time, or I could just filter. And in this case, I'm just going to filter on the Intacct T&M. And you have some options as far as what process do you want to do with this document. Do you want to just post it, submit it, or do you want to create a draft and leave it in hold for approval? In this scenario, we'll create a submitted document. You have the ability to click a pre-bill report, and this will show you the costs in detail that are available to bill. And when you're ready, you can go right into preview, which will show you the preview of all the costs in the system and how the markups are applied. So we're going to generate and click preview. And right now, we have $34,000 ready to be billed. And as you can see, most of the information is going to pre-fill in for you. One area you do need to focus on is under the job contract summary. It is going to require a billing application number to be filled out. And if you forget it, it's going to give you a warning. So we'll say this is our second billing, this is our second billing. And you'll notice as you scroll down here, there's different sections as far as where the costs are coming in from. So you'll notice we had some previous billings that we did through transactions that were done through employee expenses. So that's previous billed. But we have nothing this period in this section. No timesheet entries to bill. But you will notice down in the accounts payable expenses, we do have some transactions that came in from accounts payable. There's the total cost for those. We haven't applied contract items to these yet, so you won't see a markup yet. So what you need to do is once you see these lines, depending on how you set your contract up, you're going to apply it to one of the contract lines. So you can have one line or many lines. It depends how you want to break out your invoice. So in this scenario, we're just going to link it up how it's related to the items themselves, which is material, subcontract, material, and subcontract. And as you apply these, you'll notice over to the right, now you're seeing the markup. There's the cost, there's the 10% with the markup on it, and there's what our total billing is going to be. You could put individual descriptions on these line items, and what is really nice is you can override the billable amount. So for example, if this was supposed to be, you know, 15% or, you know, a different amount to bill, you can actually override it here as well. Then go fix the table for the next time. We'll leave it alone in this scenario. So once that's good to go, you review the items and you see your total amount to invoice is $37,840. You're going to click Create Invoice. And it will let you know that that invoice has been generated. Once that invoice has been generated, you can go and do your next billing if you have another one to do. Or you can go over into Jobs, All, and you can either go click on Print or Email, or you can view those invoices. So if we click on View, you'll notice here's the one we just generated. It should be right on top for Tritech. And if I want to view that invoice, I can click View. And it will give me a recap of what we did. Okay, so you can get back in and view it. You can print and email the document out right from here. So you can do it one at a time. You can also do a mass print or email from here if you generated multiple invoices and you want to generate them all at the same time. And you can filter out these and you can generate multiple invoices at the same time. In this scenario, let's just go into view and let's print that invoice. So we'll come over to here and we can click print and email. So if I click print, I'll click OK and it'll give me a preview right on the screen. And this document can be edited and modified through your platform services in your printed documents section. So there is my current T&M invoice format. If you're going to email it, you can click email, and now it will pre-fill in who it's supposed to go to if that customer has it set up correctly. Unfortunately, I didn't have that set up in here for that customer, but it'll pre-fill in who to send it to and who it should come from. And you can also have a particular email template set up with all the terms and the description of how you want the customer to read through an email in, you know, saying, hey, you know, here's your current invoice. Thank you for your business, however you want to lay that out with a email template. And the system will go and generate an email. Now you'll notice once we've generated that invoice, that if we go back and run that same report under Project Expense Summary, we'll select that T&M project again. We'll click View. And now you'll notice $3,600 has been billed. We have some additional ones that we can then look into and see. Maybe they didn't meet the criteria. They were in January. You know, a different date or in November. And that is how to generate a time and material billing in Intacct. Thank you.